Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Dear students, Assalamu Alaikum. I'm Sumaira Nawaz from Senior Wing Boys, APSEC 4th Road, Rawalpindi. Ramzan Mubarak to all of you. May Allah Pak shower His blessings upon us. Hope you all must be safe and sound and taking all the protecting measures to protect yourselves and your families. I hope you'll enjoy today's lecture. Now you will be thinking why? Because I'm having very interesting stories for you. So let's begin. Today we are going to start chapter number 2, that is the rise and fall of the Ottomans from 1299 till 1922. Now students, after listening to today's lecture, you will be able to understand the following topics. The first one, foundation of the Ottoman Empire and early Ottomans. Study the map of the Ottoman Empire. 7th Ottoman Caliph Mehmed II and achievements of Mehmed II. Let's discuss how the Ottoman Empire was founded. In 1298, the Seljuks, a Turkish Muslim empire, captured the area of modern-day Turkey and allowed the local tribes to stay. The Seljuks settled there and established many small kingdoms. The strongest among them was led by Osman I in western Anatolia. Anatolia is also known as Minor Asia and it is located in Turkey. Before we begin, let me tell you that Ottoman Empire was the last empire of Islamic Caliphate and the ruler of Islamic Caliphate was known as Caliph. The concept of Caliph was introduced after the death of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. If we talk about Islamic Caliphate, a Caliphate is an Islamic state under the leadership of a Caliph who is known to be a leader of entire Muslim Ummah, spiritually and politically. But remember one thing here, there is no concept of boundaries in Islam. All the areas captured by Muslims, they become the part of Islamic Caliphate. The Ottoman Empire was one of the mightiest and long-lasting dynasties in the world history. Now, you can see this is the map of Ottoman Empire. And all the red-colored areas were the part of Ottoman Empire, which consists the areas of Middle East, Eastern Europe and North Africa. The area in green color is the area of Turkey, present-day Turkey. At that time, Turkey was the center of Ottoman Empire, but it declared independence as a country in 1922 under the leadership of Mustafa Kemal Pasha Atatürk. And later on, Mustafa Kemal removed the Islamic Caliphate from Turkey. As promised earlier, now I am going to tell you the story of Osman I. The founder and the first Sultan of the Ottoman Empire, Osman I, was born on 1258 AD. He is also known as Osman Ghazi. He is one of the three sons of Ertugrul Ghazi. He took the throne at the age of 23 years. His biggest achievement is that he reunited the Seljuk Empire under his rule in 1299. He extended the Ottoman Empire by defeating the Great Byzantine Empire, which was also a huge empire. His qualities are that he was a very kind-hearted and brave leader who was expert in horse riding, sword using and battle strategies. He introduced new laws and imposed taxes. He introduced first Ottoman coins, but at the end he died of gout. Gout is the name of a disease. At that time he was the age of 68 years and he was buried in the city of Bursa. Coming to the successor. Osman I was succeeded by his son, Orhan, who captured the city of Bursa in 1326. It is that city in which his father was buried and later on he made it the capital of Ottoman Empire. Mehmed II, he is also known as Al-Fateh, mean conqueror. He was the 7th caliph of Ottoman Empire. He was born on 30th March 1432. He was the son of a successful sultan, Murad II. As a tradition, he became Sultan in 1444 when he was just 12 years of age. But seeing an immature ruler, different tribes in the state started revolting against the Ottoman Empire. And when the situation became serious, on the advice of courtiers, in 1446 his father Murad II again returned into power because as a child Mehmed was unable to fight against revolts. He was later sent for more learning. He again came into power in 1451 after the death of his father, but this time as a mature ruler. Mehmed II was a very strict ruler and a very brave soldier as well. He was fluent in 7 different languages. He was also interested in science, literature, fine arts and philosophy. He died on 3rd May 1481 at the age of 49 years with a very sudden death. Coming to his achievements, let's have a look at his achievements. He ruled the Ottoman Empire for 30 years and joined 25 campaigns himself as a front leader. His biggest achievement is conquer of Constantinople in 1453. Constantinople is the old name of Istanbul. He made it his capital and gave the name of Istanbul. He conquered Serbia in 1459. Serbia is an independent state now. Then Moria in 1460 and Anatolia in 1461. Anatolia is a Greek word and these two are cities in Greece. Then Bosnia in 1463, which is located in Europe. He gave religious freedom to all the non-Muslims, especially to the Christians, by issuing a Firman in 1463. He was first Sultan who codified criminal and constitutional laws and gave punishment for the violation of these laws. This is a short view of his achievements. Dear students, now listen carefully. From now on, you don't need to submit your assignments to your teacher. What you have to do? You have to maintain a small notepad or a booklet and keep a record of the glossary and research work. The work for this week is that you have to study the map of Ottoman Empire carefully and find out information about the Blue Mosque and the Istanbul city. I hope you understand today's lecture. Try to memorize things clearly, but still, if you feel any kind of difficulty, you are more than welcome to ask. Stay safe and healthy. Thank you and good luck.